I would ask you to remain standing as we call Vivoli Valdez to sing the national anthem. I'm sorry. We have a change in venue here. The national anthem will be sung by Michaela Gill from the Berkshire Partners Blue Hill Boys and Girls Club.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave.
If you would please be seated. Good morning. My name is Maureen Feeney, and I have the privilege of being the city clerk. I want to welcome you to historic Faneuil Hall. As the American novelist John Gardner has said, history never looks like history when you're living through it. But today we come together to celebrate and participate in Boston's rich history. Whether these newly elected councilors have partaken of this ceremony several times or are experiencing it for the first time, this is a very special day. You have shown courage in placing your names on the ballot, and today epitomizes the voters' decision to reward you for your compassion, your integrity, and dedication with their votes and your successful election. There is much anticipation in this hall because you represent the hopes of Boston's bright future. As President John F. Kennedy once said, let the public service be a proud and lively career. As we begin our journey through the next chapters in our history, we pledge our support and prayers with the thought that it is my great privilege now to bring us to this special moment by introducing Pastor Virginia Ward from the Abundant Life Church. Thank you.
Good morning. As I pray, I am mindful of other faith traditions in the room. I am praying from the perspective of a Christian. Let's pray together. Father, your name is holy. We honor you today. May your purpose for the earth, our country, our city, and our neighborhoods be accomplished. Bless the city councilors that we, the people, have selected to serve in this season. Grant them wisdom to navigate through difficult decisions. Teach them how to work as one. May the strengths of one compensate for the weaknesses of another. May they keep the city in view for all decisions. May they know the heart of the neighborhood they represent and the city as a whole. May their homes and their personal lives be blessed through their service to others. May you bless their time, their talents, and their treasures. May those who know you seek you in all things. May this team add value to the legacy of the city councilors from the city of Boston. We give you praise and thanksgiving for who you are and are ever grateful for your love towards us. Be ever present in this ceremony. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Pastor Ward, for your inspiring invocation. I would now like to read into the record a letter from the Boston Election Department, Martin J. Walsh, Mayor. To the Honorable Maureen E. Feeney, Clerk of the City of Boston, from Anita D. Tavares, Chair of the Boston Election Department, December 17, 2019, regarding November 5th, 2019 municipal election. For your records, listed below are the candidates elected to the office of City Council at Large and District City Council at the municipal election in Boston held on November 5th, 2019. City Council at Large, elected to a two-year term, Councilor Michelle Wu, 17 Augustus Avenue, District 5, Councilor Anissa Sabi George, 32 Mayhew Street, District 3, Councilor Michael F. Flaherty, 1726 Columbia Road, District 2, and Julia Mejia, 48 Capon Street, District 4. City Council by District, elected for a two-year term, Lydia Marie Edwards, 186 London Street, District 1, Edward M. Flynn, 254 Gold Street, District 2, Frank Baker, 43 Grampian Way, District 3, Andrea Joy Campbell, 37 Groveland Street, District 4, Councilor Ricardo Arroyo, 5 Wharton Court, District 5, Matt O'Malley, 51 Greta Road, District 6, Councilor Kim Janey, 27 Copeland Street, District 7. Priscilla Kenzie Bok, 53 Pinckney Street, District 8. And Liz A. Breadon, 33 Champney Street, District 9. The non-binding question, do you support the renaming change of Dudley Square to Numead Square? Yes, 24,250. No, 28,812. Sincerely, Anita Tavares, Chair of the Boston Election Commission. It is now my privilege and honor to recognize our mayor to administer the oath to our city councilors.
Okay. First of all, before we administer the oath to City Council, I want to, this room was ready to explode. So how about another round of applause for these candidates? Thank you. as the clerk was reading off the names and addresses, I was watching all the families ready to jump out of their seats. So I figured we had to get that out of the way. So I'm going to ask the council, after I state your name, and then we'll do the full oath of office. I. Do solemnly, let me start over again. So what you're going to do is going to follow everything I say, you'll repeat after me. After the word I, state your name. And then if you could raise your right hand, please. We'll do a redo. Okay. We'll get it right this time. I. Do solemnly swear. That I will bear true faith. And allegiance. To the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And will support the Constitution thereof. So help me God. I do solemnly swear that I will faithfully and impartially discharge and perform all the duties incumbent upon me as a member of the City Council of the City of Boston. According to the best of my ability and understanding. Agreeably to the rules, and regulations of the Constitution, and the laws of this Commonwealth. So help me God. I do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States. So help me God. Congratulations, Boston City Council. Thank you. I want to officially, on behalf of the City of Boston and the City Council, welcome everyone here to Faneuil Hall. Thank you for being with us today. I want to thank all the elected officials that have joined us throughout the City of Boston, the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. I want to give a shout out to Ambassador and former Mayor Ray Flynn, his wife Kathy, with us today. Thank you, Mayor Flynn. I want to congratulate the new and returning members of the Boston City Council. Congratulations, more importantly, to your family and friends here this morning and your supporters. Thank you all for being here during the campaign. I know that many of you had long days and long nights and many phone banks and many door knocking and standing out in the cold and standing out in the rain saying, why am I doing this? You did it because today. So congratulations to all the supporters that are here. As we've read, this has certainly been a momentous election in the City of Boston. We elected our first Afro-Latina immigrant of color. Might as well stay standing up for the first time our council is majority female. This will be the most diverse council in history. This is why it's not only a historic council, but it's a historic time for our entire city. If you look at the city council and the reflection of the city council, that's who we are as a city. I want to welcome our returning city councilors, Andrea Campbell, Michelle Wu, Michael Flaherty, Nisa Asabi George, Lydia Edwards, Eddie Flynn, Frank Baker, Kim Janey, and Matt O'Malley. Over the last 2 years, we've accomplished an awful lot in the city, and I look forward to our continuing partnership. To our new councilors, Julia Meijia, Kenzie Bok, Liz Breadon, and Ricardo Arroyo, we are very excited to work with all of you. This is not the first time that you've entered into public life, maybe the first time you've been elected, but certainly you've been championing your communities on issues like education, housing, and social justice. We're excited to have you and have new voices as part of the conversation as we move Boston forward into the 21st century. Tomorrow, I'll be giving my annual State of the City address. I will outline priorities for the coming year, like lifting up our schools, like growing our affordable housing, like investing in transportation. These are priorities that all of us share together, and we want to make sure that Boston is the best city for everyone who wants to be here and live here. This work requires strong partnerships. Partnership is essential for good government. If we look to Washington, D.C., we see that there's absolutely zero partnership going on in Washington, D.C. As a city council, and I have solid relationships that's moving Boston forward. It's how we passed responsible budgets to make bold investments in our neighborhoods. It's how we moved our city forward on our climate goals, housing production goals, and so much more that we've done. We still have a lot of work ahead of us to rebuild and expand the middle class, to invest in our students' success, to make sure everyone has a place to call home, and to make sure that we leave no one behind. In these very divisive times, Boston can and must show a way forward. We're going to continue to lead with our values, and we're going to go to work together to tackle our biggest challenges in the spirit of collaboration. That's what the people of Boston elected all of us to do. I'm honored to do this important work alongside you. Once again, to the Boston City Council, congratulations and Happy New Year.
And now it is my privilege to ask all of you to stand as we call to the dais Reverend Dr. Arthur T. Gerald, Jr. from the historic 12th Baptist Church.
To God be the glory for this momentous occasion. Let us bow for prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, for every ending there is a beginning. For every memory there is a dream ahead. As we conclude this inaugural ceremony, may you bless each and every one of our council members. May you bless our mayor. May you bless this city. May your grace be sufficient to cover a multitude of concerns and a multitude of needs. Because without you, we can do nothing. And with you, Lord, we can do everything. And now may the Lord bless this council and keep this council. May the Lord make his face to shine upon this city and be gracious unto this city. And may the Lord lift up the light of his counsel upon each of us and all of us and give us your peace for our minds, your joy for our hearts, and your hope eternal for your soul, our souls. Now I pray that we'll go in God's grace and peace. In the matchless mighty name of Jesus the Christ, I pray. Amen. Say amen again.
Amen.
Shout it out like you believe it.
Amen.
God bless you, City of Boston.
And now we will have Denzel Scarlett play God Bless America.
short. Sorry.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairie, to the ocean, fine with foam. Oh, God bless America, my home, sweet home.